Okay, well, this is going to be a long video. I'm going to discuss a little bit of philosophy based upon art, delivered through a transcendental moment right here through birds. I drew these birds, and each bird represents a different facet, a different philosopher, a different philosopher with a different take. Going at life from different variations, different variables, all necessary and needed, or there wouldn't be satisfaction in a way. So yes, interesting. Oh, it is a little bright, but right here, we'll start with this one. I'll try to make them not a queasic experience. But yes, this little one here. Right there. He represents materialism. He's the largest of all of the birds. He is the one who has claimed the largest flower. Pretty much, he is. Yeah, I have dirty fingernails. Sorry for that. But yeah, he is the one who is insistent on the status quo staying and remaining as is, for a continuation of like the now experience, and that there does not need to ever be a step back. There doesn't even need to be a further step forward, just a continuance in the way it is now, as if a thread woven through another strand in a piece of materialism. One at a time. Now, yes, no sacrifice. No sacrifices to be made from this individual. As if a grandfather. This is a grandfathering, a grandfather, a clock type item. He represents the staid, the stale, the disheartening that a lot of us feel. This bird is quite dejected by the others, because you notice his size in proportion already. So he is also representative of this particular life experience that we have right now, all over. Now, there we are right there. This little dude at the bottom. Now he is. Gosh dang it, sorry for the zoom. He is the look at him, look at the aura. He sees himself. He sees. See that grounding? He's grounded and he is staring straight through as a reflectionist into his aura. Now, because he is a reflectionist, because he's grounded, he's into his aura, he is the most into spiritual. He's most into the spiritual inhabitants, not afraid of addressing narcissism in pretty much all. But yes, continually encounter fluctuation with color. And how his moment, his day, is influenced, and how he influences through his own well, metamorphosis, as if he is a butterfly changing shape and color. So he is a reflectionist, and yet he is also a metamorphic reflectionist, meaning almost a shape changer, yet a color changer. So yes, reflecting upon all kinds of things, and even able to inhabit other life forms, go there as an existentialism, and be there as if he wants to be a bumblebee, and entertain that spirit. If he wants to be something completely disengendered to him, like a shoe, or if he wants to be a dog, he has that capability. So yes, very interesting character. Now, I have quite a few. See, who do I have here? No, not him yet. You notice most are hymns. this little guy up there. Now he's the jester. Kind of reminds me of the little Yorkshire Terrier type of a bird. Gosh dang, sorry you can't see him clearly. But yes, he likes to live a sheltered life. Quite safe. And yet survives through the inhabitants of this comic character, and finds that there's no way through this life. There's no reason for it even being, unless comedy exists. Yeah, so he is a bit of the airplane, what do you call that man, or the woman who twirls it? Yeah, he's a bit of that. And yeah, careful on the drinks, this little dude. Careful on the drinks at the party. Okay, up at the very top here, you can see him. He's a duck. Mr. No, not this one. Yeah, the one at the very top is the duck. And yeah, lofty ideals. Mr. Cloud up there, facing life completely through idealism. Not understanding why the others don't want that perfection. As you notice his perch there, my goodness. He's perfectly balanced. He's reached that attainment. He's up at the top there, pretty much. Just perfect. And so that's where he lives. He lives pretty much there, in the attainment of perfection. And yeah, his constraints they're not really constraints, but yeah, his confines more, or why the others don't want that shine, don't want that attainment. But yeah, Mr. Lofty Ideals doesn't want to see the other, either. He doesn't want to see the disperfect cloud formation. He wants to only envision life in the good. So a bit skewed, a bit one way in thought. All right. Well, I guess I'll go with Mr. up here at the top. Now this one is my little Nostradamic character. Gosh dang, I can't get the focus. Yeah. He's the grump. He's the one who roars the most. He's the monarch of... He is loud. And yet he sees the future more than the others. And so that's why he is so boisterous in his character. And so over-intellectualized, and yet the others are like, what's wrong with him? So yeah, he has quite a bit of stompage in his passion. He's in his passion for deliverance, because he does see what's ahead. He sees what's over there, and the others are not listening. So he is the one who has the drum, and and endures frustration again and again and again. Very, very intellectual character, and yet, right there, he's pretty much directly over materialism. Another combative to him, often. So, and in the center here, this little bird, he's the one who's confined within books, within language, within the speak of other philosophers. He's actually unfree to even philosophize. He's a listener. That's not a problem to be the listener, but he's almost afraid to go forward with his own. So he is minorly squandered in his intelligence. It's almost as if his intelligence has limited him, because he knows so much, he's almost unfree to leap off that cliff and come to his own conclusions and make his own deductions. So that's where he is living. So anyway, there's my little dudes. I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, sorry about all that dirty fingernails, but my gosh, I was out in the garden today and yow. Putting my hands in there, and I don't know. I don't really live here on this, like, because obviously I'm the artist of it, so yeah. Because I'm the artist of it, the little birds. Yeah. Well, anyway, there's a lot more inside there and a lot more into them, and I suppose for the dude in the middle, I could write a book about them, but I'm not going to. Yeah. Anyway, I also like to just show them because I can't seem to save anything photo-wise. I don't know. A lot of things just disappear with the colored pencil. So yeah, was that too long? It might have been.